Thank you, Chair. I think, as far as I'm concerned, that as long as this development is time limited and that the usage afterwards, I think it is an appropriate use of the space. Surrounding venues, I think it's a totally appropriate use of the space as a temporary issue, with the proviso that, as far as I'm concerned on the planning board, our first issue is the residential accommodation. We've demonstrated this already, but I'm pleased to hear that that will be something for the future.
Can I ask members of the board who have raised the issue of limiting or putting a condition on the mix among the events? In item 5.3, where it is listed, are you happy with that? 20 conferences, 10 awards, 25 corporate parties, 12 brand events, 8 music concerts, concerts and 8 exhibitions. Do you want a minute to look at that? Sorry, it's 5.3 in the addendum report. The multi-purpose event centre is anticipated to host, on average, it's an industry anticipated, 20 conferences, 10 awards, 25 corporate parties, 12 brand events, 8 music concerts and 8 exhibitions. Would that seem something? Yeah, Councillor Fletcher.
Chair, it seems to me that is sort of a detail within the report that is not really something we should be basing that kind of a restriction on, I don't think. I think that's there as information, background information as to the anticipated scale of the usage. And is that not something that, as Evan said, licensing will consider in more detail than we're able to?
Okay, if Councillor Adams?
I'm opposed to that. I think we need to reinforce these issues. Licensing committees can be persuaded more easily than perhaps planning boards can. I'm much more comfortable with these purposes and these uses in the body of the planning consent, which gives us more strength in dealing with any events which are out of some of these priorities. And also, I think we need to look at times of usage.
Okay, but Norman, just to be clear, if you wanted to include a condition, it would be along the lines set out in paragraph 5.3. No, yes. Members of the board generally in agreement with that point? Just the same points you made, Councillor Fletcher. So, Councillor Bird.
Yes, thank you, Chair. I mean, it would just mean the wording would be different. The multi-purpose event centre is anticipated to host the average pound.
Yes.
It would be a condition, so the wording would change then.
Yeah. And I just want to check. It is within our gift to impose that as a condition.
Yes, I think there's a reason, a planning reason.
Okay. So, it is within our gift to impose that as a condition. Is that something, just an answer from the board, if you think that that's, and you're agreeable with what's set out in the application? You look doubtful still, Councillor Fletcher, but the advice from
I understand the point you made. My feeling is that it's probably within the purview of licensing to restrict the opening times and the number of events. I think if we're going to attach a condition, I think it needs to be slightly more flexible than just an average. I mean, it's perhaps a maximum.
More flexible or less flexible?
Well, I mean, the way it's removed is one on average, and the point of an average is that it can be up or down. So I think
So in the condition wouldn't say on average. The condition would list this as a condition. Yes.
But we're saying what's written there as an average is now going to become a maximum.
Yes, that's exactly right.
That's what we're doing. Yeah. Okay, so, does everyone just want to move to deliberation? No. Do you want to discuss this more?
Can we vote on that proposal for that condition?
Well, apparently, it to the vote, I'll put it to the vote with that condition in it.
Have we decided to present that condition?
I'll move that.
Can you just bear with me? I'm getting conflicting signals from that, and I do need to clarify this. So everybody just bear with me for one moment. I'm going to switch the mic off and I'm going to get clarification because I'm getting conflicting. So I can put it to the board separately, and I'm going to put it to the board. That was moved by Norman. Is it seconded that we put that as a condition in the application? I just seconded to the vote, to the vote to the board. We put it in as a condition. Yeah?
Yes.
Those in favour? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Those against? 1. Any abstentions? I'm an abstention. So now, is there the board coming for me to just propose that we determine this one way or the other?
I'm sorry to make the point, Chair, but do we not need some people to look at house operations as well? Because that's what we normally do as well.
Is that not licensing house operations?
No.
That's the point, and that's what council. Right, okay. Do you want to propose, Norman, some hours of operation that we
can? The applicants might be said that they don't anticipate the events lasting much more than 11 o'clock. So if we put, say, 12 o'clock, which includes half an hour for clearance and for what have you.
Okay.
Can I say, there's nothing to stop the applicant in due course if they demonstrate that they're managing the thing properly to apply for an amendment to extend the house operation. This way, we're protected. This way.
Okay.
You know.
Okay. So you're moving that. Seconded? I seconded it. I put it to the vote already, Councillor Dillon. I'm sorry, I just need to vote on that. I'm sorry. Your clarification?
No, that's what I'm saying. If we didn't get a chance for anyone else to make a comment about the term of powers.
So Norman is proposing that events take place up to midnight. Is that correct?
What we would do is say the events last until a specified time, and then we allow additional time for people to disperse and for closing down operations. So normally we have a Senate rules which says all events will start at 11 o'clock plus an hour for clearing up and what have
you. Okay. Are we clear on what Norman is proposing? We are.
Pick a number.
Vicky, do you want to clarify?
Absolutely.
Would you like to repeat what Norman said and make it clear, please? I have to confess to everyone, I'm having problems hearing. I'm having problems hearing that microphone, which is not helping.
My understanding of what Councillor Adams said is the events will go on to 11 p.m. and then there will be a period of time for clearing up and vacating the premises, and then it will be finally shut.
Are we clear?
Chair, can I just clarify?
Yeah.
Councillor Adams is saying we normally do this on an annual unit of the committee. Is that correct, or do we normally leave this to licensing?
There is nothing to stop you putting hours of operation on a proposal like this, provided there are planning matters, planning reasons to do so, in the same way licensing also covers hours of operation, but there's nothing to stop you doing it under planning.
So, Norman, are you moving that? Is that seconded? Well, I'm going to second it. Okay, votes in favour? Okay, I think that's fallen. So it remains with the condition on the number of events each year. So, whilst we would like to see this land used for residential property, which I think was the original understanding of Barclay Homes, nonetheless, they have indicated that within that timescale they will be building 3,000 homes, yeah? They have asked for a temporary planning permission for 10 years. I am right in thinking that the Coach Park has been granted planning permission for 10 years till 2028. 2028, not 2020-17. Can I just be clear on that? It wasn't granted a year ago for 10 years, till 2017.
It was granted in 2017.
Okay,
so it's granted for 11 years.
So if the two applications close at the same time, we would expect this land to revert back to residential use. And on that basis, I'm going to put it to the board that they vote in favour of the application for a temporary period of 10 years. All those in favour, subject to the conditions that we have agreed tonight about the events, which are those proposed by the applicant anyway. All those in favour?